Hi everyone, Miles Austin here with Fill the Funnel, and this is the second video showing you a second new feature that has been recently rolled out into your Zoom account. The important thing to note here is that make sure you've gone to the upper right-hand corner in Zoom, click on your avatar or your photo, and make sure you have the most recent updates. A lot of times people don't think about that all the time, so you need to have that to make sure you've got the most current upgrade available in your account. So now what we're going to show you in this video is to highlight, a really cool upgrade for anyone that's a presenter, a teacher, a coach, a speaker, a trainer who wants to share PowerPoint slides with an audience, and you can make it very seamless. So what I'm going to do is show you how you go through that now. So within Zoom, you want to go down to Share Screen here in the bottom of the screen. You want to click that. And you want to go up to Advanced, which is up here in the top of your screen. It's the middle tab. And you'll see something here that says Beta. It's the new PowerPoint as virtual background. You want to select that and then click Share. And then you're going to have to go down to find a PowerPoint presentation. So I just grabbed a random presentation here that I want to show you a couple different things to be aware of when you're doing it. So you'll see what's happened. Now it's moved me down to the bottom right corner. If you click on your image, you can see you can move this around. You can put yourself wherever you'd like to within the presentation. Lower right seems to be fairly standard. You can also minimize, maximize. You can make yourself a lot bigger if you want to. And so I think kind of where the standard preset was usually works pretty good. I might make it a little bit smaller. Okay, so, and you click off and you're there. So now you can see I've got my PowerPoint presentation. So if I'm sharing the information, I can still be on the slide, I can still highlight and make emphasis, but you have now an ability to present your screen. So if you look down here on the bottom, you've got the slide movement, and you can kind of see one of the points I wanted to make to you is when you do your slides now, you want to make sure that you build them and lay them out with this specific thing in mind right here. See where I am. I can fix this short term by making myself a little smaller, but normally it's not going to be the case, right? So you don't want yourself sticking over your slides. So you'll see what happens there, but I want to give you this as a heads up and just something to be aware of when you're using this really cool new feature. So you can see most of the time, I found white backgrounds are good, dark backgrounds are fine. A solid color usually is best. So you can see here, here's a full screen graphic. And you can see, you can still talk to it, still make your points, and you're still in the bottom corner where you've laid yourself out to be. Here's some more text slides. Again, depends on how you do it. Having graphics is not a big deal. Just remember in layout, you want to make sure that you're positioning them so you're not in the way. Here's another example of a full screen image. And then I want to get you, there's one in the bottom. There you go, I'll show you. So look what happens. You can just, again, think about it. If you look at this image, it's really an impactful image for whatever the messages we're trying to communicate, but I'm kind of lost down here. So again, be aware of that. You make yourself bigger and talk over it if you want to. If this is a part of your presentation, you can talk about what's going on in the audience or whatever it might be, but it gives you an ability to be seen in a unique way. And like all new things, all the cool kids are going to be doing this, and it'll be fun for you if you can be one of the first cool kids, and people are going to be asking you. I assure you, they're going to be asking you, hey, how'd you do that? Because it's something that hasn't been out before. So hope it helps. Pretty cool feature, and I think you'll understand why it's something that people are really going to enjoy. So hope that helps and you've got some benefit out of it. If you missed the first one about the new blur background, go back and watch that one as well. And I wish you the best and good luck in your Zoom meetings.